Good morning, good morning. Welcome to the morning's worship. I am Reverend Durbundale Taylor, pastor for the Linstead and Trafalgar Submission Churches. We're just waiting on a few more persons to come in to the live as we get ready to worship God, as we get ready to hear from God. Go ahead and invite somebody to tune in. Come into this live as a word awaits you this morning. So go ahead. Invite somebody. Send, share this broadcast so your friend, your family can tune in to the broadcast of the Pentecostal Submission Church, Linstead, and also on our sister church, Trafalgar Submission. So go ahead, I'm going to give you another minute or so to go ahead and invite somebody to join this broadcast. While you do that, just go ahead and enjoy Marvin's "You Shall Live." Go ahead, invite someone to come on in. Go ahead and the bad person's in. It's morning worship, divine worship. We have a fallback speaker waiting in the waiting room to break the word for us to hear. God bless you. Again, good morning to the live broadcast of the Pentecostal Submission Church and Trafalgar Submission Church located in St. Catherine, Jamaica. I am Reverend Durbin Taylor, the pastor of both churches. On the behalf of the ministerial team, I want to welcome you to this live broadcast. As you know, COVID-19, as they call it, the global pandemic, have limited our attendance to the physical building, but we were always cognizant of the fact that we carry the temple. We are carriers of the glory. And we were cognizant that our bodies are the temple of the living God and the Holy Spirit dwells therein. And therefore, even though we cannot gather in numbers more than 10, we are still being heard, not only locally, but internationally, all over the world. And so, as we say, church is not out. Some people say, yeah, church still a keep. And so, we have been coming to you weekly via this medium, both on Sundays and on Wednesdays. And we continue to invite you to join us as we bring to you the undiluted word of Almighty God. What a blessing these past weeks have been. Friends, we also continue to pray for our country. As you know, we have increased in the number of cases of the novel coronavirus, COVID-19. We have also had an additional death, but we still believe and declare that God is in control. So please remember the families of those who have lost loved ones. for those who have been infected with the virus. Remember also those who are on the front line, the medical professionals, those who are in the security forces. We want to remember them in our prayers. And so we invite you on this Tuesday to join our prayer meeting. We will be live on Zoom. And so stay tuned for those meeting IDs so you can join in and pray with the prayer team. I want to also encourage us that as we go out, for those of us in St. Catherine, we have the lockdown, as we call it, has been lifted. But we also have to take personal responsibility for our own health. And therefore, I encourage you to observe all the protocols. Remember, wash your hands, sanitize, social distancing, and of course, wear your mask. And if you have no business on the streets, as they say, tana yayad. Friends, it is going to be our own personal responsibility that is going to keep us safe from this virus. And of course, our own trust and faith in Almighty God that these plagues shall not come nigh our dwelling. But we also believe that even if we become infected, that He is a healing Jesus. And God forbid, if we become infected and die, we believe that we are going to a better place. So friends, let us not remain fearful, but let's remain faithful, that God is able to do exceedingly abundantly above all we can ever ask or think. So good morning to all those who have joined us, those from the local churchy, and those from the region, and of course, those from other churches and those from overseas. God bless you. We want to say thanks for joining us, to those who make it the point of their duty to join us every Sunday and every Wednesday. And for those who are new, God bless you. We continue to invite you to share with us. Remember to like, share, comment, and of course, go over to our YouTube page and subscribe. Also, click the notification icon so you can be notified of all our postings and when we go live. In closing of my little epilogue here, I want to remind us that there are those among us who are vulnerable and most vulnerable to this disease, and there are some who are less fortunate. We at the Linstead City Mission Church have already done one round of welfare, giving back. We made packages and we gave back to the church membership and persons in the community. We have to continue this project. We want to continue this project because this epidemic has caused so many people to be out of a job. There are persons who are laid off. There are persons who still can't do their little hustle, as we call it here. And so we want to continue to serve our elderly and those who are less fortunate among us. And so we want to continue to encourage those who share with us, those who can, to sow into the welfare project. Now, I want to be very specific. So into the welfare project, which will give back to those who are less fortunate among us. If you look at the bottom of the screen, you will find the ways in which you can contact us about giving, or you can also make direct transfers to our bank account. It will be going to a worthy cause. I know that in these times, it is very quick for persons to say, hey, you know, the pastors are out of offering, are out of tithes, etc. But I want to say very publicly, categorically, that I am fully employed. And so, hear what? This that we're asking you for is strictly towards the welfare project to help those who are less fortunate among us. All right, so share with your friends, invite somebody to give, as it is indeed the bond and the true Jamaican spirit of caring for each other that is going to get us through this pandemic. And so God bless you as you give. Let us bow our heads as we approach our Father, as we bring issues before Him, and as we give Him thanks and praise for what He continues to do for us, and also for the speaker that is coming to us shortly. Let us assume a posture of prayer. Father, in the name of Jesus, we honor you. You are great. You're a mighty God. You're an everlasting God. You are the Prince of Peace. You are the Rose of Sharon. You are the bright and morning star. Father, we just bless your name this morning because you're simply awesome. We give you thanks, Lord, that you have spared our lives amid this crisis, this pandemic. Many have died. But here we are, Lord, in the land of the living. We don't take that for granted. We thank you for your mercies that are new every morning. And Lord, because we have life this morning, we just lift up our hands and we bless your majestic name. We thank you, Lord, that you have spared not only our lives, but Lord, many can look at their families this morning. We have received no death news. We have received no news that our families are infected. But God, we remember those who may have received such news, and we pray, Lord, for comfort. Lord, you declare in your words that blessed are they that mourn, for they shall be comforted. I pray, God, for families that are mourning this morning the loss of a loved one, whether it is by God, COVID-19 or other means. I pray that your peace that passes all understanding will, Lord, bring calm to them this morning. Lord, we remember those who continue to fight on the front line against this virus. The nurses, the doctors, the porters, the police, the soldiers, the firemen, the emergency medical technicians. Lord, everyone, Lord, who still has to be on the front line, every essential worker. For those, Lord, who still have to do their hustle, trying to make ends meet. For those, Lord, who have been laid off. For those, Lord, who have lost their jobs. I pray, God, that you will, oh God, supply every individual need this morning. Father God, we pray for the government. We pray for the leaders, oh Lord, on both sides of the fence and every legislator in this country. God, as we try to navigate through these uncharted waters, I pray that you'll give them knowledge, wisdom, and understanding. Father, through the words of our anthem, we declare that eternal Father, bless our land. Guard us with your mighty hand. Keep us free from evil powers and be your light through countless hours. To our leaders, great defender today, we ask, grant true wisdom from above. And we continue to declare, Lord, that justice, truth should be ours forever because Jamaica, land we love. Bless this land. I pray, God, that you'll continue, God, give us, Lord, comfort as we know that, Lord, in the end, there will be glory after this. Lord, we prepare our hearts and our minds for this glory that is coming. And I believe that it won't be long. And so we bless you this morning. Lord, remember every listener on this live broadcast. I pray, God, that your Holy Spirit right now engulf their homes, engulf their environment. I pray for the word that is about to come and the speaker. I pray, God, that, Lord, you will overshadow the man of God. I pray, God, that you touch his lips with a life cool, just as you did to Isaiah. And Lord, use him, oracle, in Jesus' name, amen. God bless you. It is indeed time for the word. And this morning to share with us. We have a very powerful man of God in the person of the minister, Tevaun Brown. And indeed, he has been a blessing to us. And God has been using him mightily. He continues to speak at various events. He has spoken at various events for us. He has spoken at conferences, camps, local churches, other churches. And God continues to minister to him and continues to use him. God bless you, Sir Brown.
Bless you, Dr. Taylor. Morning.
Good morning, sir. Before you break into the word, how has COVID-19 been treating you? How have you been navigating this period?
Well, I wouldn't say how COVID has been treating me. I would say how I have been treating COVID. social distancing. But it has been a series where I believe, you know, a lot of persons are really finding out who they really are. You know, a perfect example is that, you know, sometimes we groom ourselves to show the people, but now we have to show them the real side of us. So we really, you know, and somebody said the best parent is transparency, you know. Right. And it's been a good season. What you can do, but is you can self-invest, you know, read,
right.
Read books, read, you know, pray, fast, read, right. But make sure at the end of the day, when COVID is over, you have enough to give to fulfill a need that the world needs.
Amen. All right, listeners, God bless you. Today we are on the theme, "This is not your end." Amen. And I'm looking forward to that word that the Lord will speak to us. And so, man of God, God bless you. The floor is now yours. And again, thank you for sharing with us through this video. God bless you.
Amen. Amen. No problem. Thank you for having me. Again, greetings to Dr. Evan Taylor and his wonderful wife, Lady Taylor, as well. All those who are watching online from the U.S., from the Caribbean, all over the world, the Lord bless you. And the Lord strengthen you. And I pray that you are safe, sanctified, and sanitized. Amen. Praise God. So I would like to speak to you from just a passage of scripture, Matthew chapter 4. I know we're at home, but I believe everybody has their Bible, right? So Matthew chapter 4, reading from verse 17 to verses 19. All right, praise God. Matthew chapter 4. And this scripture is basically speaking to us after Jesus began his ministry. And he had an encounter with his first two disciples. Amen. Praise God. So this is what he says. From that time, From that time, Jesus began to preach and say, "Repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand." And Jesus, walking by the Sea of Galilee, saw two brothers, Simon called Peter and Andrew his brother, casting their nets into the sea, for they were fishermen. And then he said to them, "Follow me, and I will make you fishers of men." Amen. Make you fishers of men. They immediately left their nets and followed him. Praise God. The word of God is already blessed. Amen. The prayer was released for the word, and we thank God one more time for what he has released and for what he's about to continue to say. Amen. Good morning again. Amen to my Linstead family. Amen. I always say this, if I should ever move to Linstead, there's only one church I would go, and that is Linstead. But I would like to give you a quote as I begin today from John C. Maxwell, and he says that the leader knows the way, goes the way, and shows the way. And then he said it again. He says that the leader knows the way, shows the way, and goes the way. One of the most important things that we have to understand and we need in this time is good leadership. Yeah, we need good leadership in this season. For what is happening now, it is the leadership of the government, the leadership of those who are in power, that will determine a lot of things. You know, at the end of the day, this is what must be done, is that as long as the leader is doing what he what he should do, then the people cannot blame the leader. And it is important that leaders in this time, you know, that we arise and we do what we are called to do. So one of the most important things that we need in this time is good leadership. And we must understand now, when we look at Jesus Christ was not only a prophet, he was not only a priest, not only a king, but he was also a leader. Jesus was also a leader. And one of the things about Jesus is that anyone that he called, Jesus called leaders. Amen. I've always been saying this, that prophets, no prophets, preachers, no preachers, leaders, no leaders. I remember I was at a service one day when I used to attend the Pentecostal Gospel Temple. I needed to leave to go home, and I was playing the keyboard. And there was somebody in the congregation. When I looked in the congregation, I saw a young man. And immediately the Lord said to me that he is a musician as well. So I called him up and said, "Can you play the keyboard?" And he said, "Yes." So God provided somebody who was able to fill the spot for me, amen, that so I could leave. You must understand, ladies and gentlemen, that it is important that you be in the right position, the right place, at the right time, that God can call you to fill a space that will be vacant when someone leaves. The Bible says that as it relates to Elijah and Elisha, amen, that Elisha watched Elijah so much, to the point that Elijah said to him, "If you see me going up, amen, then you will have what you have asked for." It is important that you pay keen attention to your leaders in this season. It is important that you pay keen attention not only to your physical leaders, but also your spiritual leaders. Amen. It is important that you pay attention to what God is saying, what he's doing, how he's moving. Jesus said something powerful, and he said, "What I see my Father do, that I do. What I hear him say, that I will say." No, let me say this to you. Some things that God will tell you to do, amen, will not, some men will see it as foolishness and say, "Why would God want to do this now at this time and at this point?" You must understand, the Bible says that the wisdom of God is foolishness to man, but the foolishness of God is still wiser than the wisdom of men. You have to understand in this season, if God is saying to you, as the man of God is saying, sow a seed, amen, don't hold back your hand. Release that seed. Let me give you a testimony. I remember an individual said to me that, "Man of God, I want to bless you. I want to bless the ministry." And the same day that same day the individual released the seed, amen, that 3 to 5 hours after, that individual got blessed also. Amen. Somebody called that individual also and said, "I want to be a blessing to you." So because she was a blessing to me, amen, someone became a blessing to her. Amen. Don't be afraid to be like an Isaac in the season where you sow in the time of famine. I guarantee you, you will reap what you sow. Amen. Praise God. And so as the book of Matthew brings to us a very interesting story of the ministry of Jesus. Amen. The Bible said, "From that time, Jesus began to preach and to say, 'Repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand.'" Now, the theme is, this is not your end. And I'm going to speak it from two sides, two dimensions. Amen. This is not your end. Jesus began to preach and to repent. Now, you must understand that before you can lead someone, you have to be operating in your assignment and your calling. Amen. Before Jesus called anybody, he began to operate in his assignment and his calling. Amen. He began to flow in what God called him to flow into. Why? Because persons are going to follow you, ladies and gentlemen, based on what you are carrying. You know, persons are going to follow you based on what you are carrying. Amen. Whenever somebody comes under a leader, there is something that is in the leader that the individual sees and that the individual is going after. Her. Amen. Let me bring back Elisha and Elijah. Elisha wanted a double portion of Elijah's spirit, and so that was his objective. That is what allowed him, despite what people are saying, amen, to continue to be consistent in following his leader. Amen. Praise God. So you need to see something that is in your leader, which means, ladies and gentlemen, your leader has to be carrying something in order for you to see something. Your leader has to have something in order for those who are following the leader to want something. Amen. And so Jesus was operating in his ministry. He was flowing. And while he was operating in his ministry, he now got to a point, ladies and gentlemen, that the Bible says, and Jesus was now walking by the Sea of Galilee. No, no, no. Watch this. When we look at the regular things of life, we will understand that. Amen. Walking, and he saw two brothers, Simon and Peter, and his brother Andrew. Amen. Amen. Casting their nets into the sea, for they were fishermen. Let me read just a bit. The Bible says that Jesus went walking. Jesus went walking. There is something very important here. Normally, ladies and gentlemen, it is us that goes to look for a leader. But Jesus, now being a leader, began to walk and look for other leaders. My God Almighty. Oh God, this is what the scripture says. The scripture says that it is not us. It is not us that has chosen God, but it is God that has chosen us. You have to understand this. Now, Jesus, he went about looking for leaders, and when he was walking, he found two of his first leaders, and he found them. Amen. They were two brothers, and these two brothers, amen, they were fishermen. They were casting their nets into the sea because they were fishermen. You got to get this. It means that, ladies and gentlemen, Jesus found them doing something. Yes, you have to understand that God is always looking for people who are doing something. My God, you have to be doing something. It doesn't matter how small it is. God is looking for people who are doing something. Even though Gideon was hiding, Gideon was in the press doing something. Amen. You've got to get this. Even though he was afraid, but still doing something. Amen. I get what I'm saying, ladies and gentlemen. So Jesus now looks at them and he sees them. Amen. And he recognized immediately what their occupation was. But Jesus now said something very powerful. He said, follow me and I will make you fishers of men. My God Almighty. So listen now, they were fishermen, but Jesus now divided the word into two and said, I will make you fishers of men. Now watch this. Jesus did not change their profession. What he did was maximize it. My God, he maximized it to its true ability. Can I say this to you? You can be doing something in the physical right now that you don't even understand that the physical is demonstrating what your spiritual assignment will be. These men did not understand that even though they were fishermen in the physical, in the spiritual they were fishers of men. Now you have to understand this also, that a leader has the ability to see who you are even when you can't see who you are. A leader has the ability, ladies and gentlemen, to see who you will be 5 years, 10 years down the line, even when you yourself cannot see. What is it called? It is called the vision of a leader. My God, it is called the ability to see far beyond what you are seeing. Now, God said to Abraham, I know where you are right now, you are seeing, but as far as your eyes can see, that will be yours. Can I ask you a question this morning? Despite COVID-19, what are you seeing? Can you see far beyond COVID, or are you still looking at your current? I would like to say this to you, that your current might be your present, but your current is not your permanent. My God, your current might be your present, but your present is not your permanent. It means that where you are now, ladies and gentlemen, is not where you will remain if you, my God Almighty, if you will not remain there if you begin to do something. So you're in the time of private. You're in the season where you cannot fellowship with others as though you would want to, but are you investing in yourself privately? This is what God says, that I am the God that sees in secret. And when I see in secret, I am going to reward you openly. So it means that even though, my God, COVID-19 is causing us to remain on the inside, God is able to turn a bad thing into a beneficial thing, my God, that will lift your life to become a beneficial life. My God, this is what Joseph said, amen, that COVID meant it for evil, but God turned it around for your good. Can I say this to you? That after this pandemic, you're about to become the best thing since sliced bread. God is about to deposit something in you that the world has need of. God is about to deposit something in you, my God Almighty, that your family has need of. Can I say this to you? That where you are now is just a preparation for where you are going to be. So Jesus saw them and he said, listen, if you follow me, I will make you fishers of men. Here is point number three, that in order for you to become, you have to first follow. My God, so the becoming is in the following. Oh, yes. Before you can become, you have to first follow. This is what Jesus said. Jesus, this is what Paul says, rather. He says, follow me and I will make you. My God, Paul says, rather, follow me as I follow Christ. Why? Because as Paul was following Christ, Christ was making him into the apostle. Paul, God was making him into the author of the books. God was making him into somebody. In order for you to become, you have to first follow. Let me ask you a question. Who are you following? Blessed is the man that walketh not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor standeth in the seat of the scornful, nor sit in the seat of the scornful, nor standeth in the way of sinners. Who are you following? Who are you looking on? Where is your eyes? What are your eyes seeing in this season? You have to understand, ladies and gentlemen, that this is just a preparation for your transition. This is just a preparation for what God is about to do in your life. Because what? This is not your end. Can I say this to somebody? Amen. Peter and his brothers were fishermen, but that was not their end. My God, their father might have died as a fisherman. Their great-grandfather might have died as a fisherman. But let me say this to you. Your leader has the ability, my God, to look at you and say, where you are now, that is not where you are meant to be. This is just the platform. Elisha, my God, was farming the grounds. He had oxen and he was tilling the ground. But when he met Elijah, he realized that, my God, that he realized that his profession was not farming or tilling the ground, but his profession was to be an accurate prophet to the nations. Can I say this to you? When you meet your leader, you will see who you are and you will see what you are to become. That is why you have to be very careful about those who you give authority over you, because who you submit to, that is going, my God, those are the persons that you will pull from. You need strong leadership in this time. You need leaders that will pour into you. And one of the things that Jesus did and he kept on doing was that he always poured into those who were in the inner circle. My God, that is one side of this message this morning. Amen. That your leader has the ability to pull out who you are. The next side of it is this. Amen. That you have been stuck. You have been in a position where you have been doing what the family says. You have been operating according to the laws and the governing and the order of what you are in. The Lord says to tell you this morning, amen, that your spiritual present is about to change. This is not your end. My God, you might feel as if you are ordinary. You might feel as if nothing is working for you. You might feel as if, my God, when COVID came in, that my life turned upside down. But can I say this to you, that this is not your end. God is about to deliver. God is about to break you out. God is about to set you free. God is about to show you that you are more anointed than you know. God is about to bring you to a place that you realize, my God, that there is greatness on the inside of you. I say this to you, that God is about to come where you are, and he's about to give you a prophecy. As a matter of fact, he's about to tell you who you are, that you are a man of God, a woman of God, a businessman, an entrepreneur. God is about to show you that where you currently are right now, it is not your end, but you are about to encounter something that nobody else in your family encountered. My God, you're about to walk into something that nobody else walked into. Can I bring it even deeper? Because Peter was following Jesus. Peter was able to do what Jesus did. Peter was the first man in his family, my God, to walk on water. Can I say this to that? You are about to break, my God, a record in your family, because this is not your end. Because Paul says the present suffering of this time are not able to be compared with the glory that shall be revealed in you. What you are seeing now might be dirt, but when God begins to dig the dirt out of your well, you're about to, my God, cause water to flow out of you. I said, those who despised you, those who turned their backs on you, those who rejected the well that had no water. I said, when Jesus begins to dig your life again, you're about to spring forth water out of your belly. Shall flow rivers of living water. Who am I talking to this morning? This is not your end. The Lord God is about to raise you up and lift you up for you to understand that in this season, my God, your life is not over, but your life is going to a next dimension. Can I talk to an entrepreneur? My God, your business is not going down, but God is about
My God Almighty, God is about to give you something fresh. God is about to give you something new. The idea that you had before, you thought that was it. But my God Almighty, God is about to give you another idea. God is about to give you another push. God is about to give you another energy. God is about to lift you up to a next dimension. Because what you are seeing now, my God might be saying to you that it is over. No. But what you are seeing now is actually saying to you, ladies and gentlemen, that there is more in you than you know, and I'm about to dig out those hidden things. I'm about to dig out those hidden treasures. I'm about to dig out those hidden blessings. I'm about to dig out those hidden talents. I'm about to dig out that hidden ability. I'm about to show you that you had more in you than you know, my God. I'm about to show you that inside of you, my God, was treasure hidden, but I needed to get you into a secret place. I needed to get you into a dark place that you begin to dig what is on the inside of you. My God Almighty, this is not your end. This is not your end. Woo! This is not your end. Listen, if you can type it, I want you to hashtag right now. Hashtag and write hashtag not my end. Hashtag not my end. Listen, if you can do that right now, hashtag not my end. You need to write it. Praise God. And if you believe it, listen, you need to send up some hearts. I'm sending up some hearts right now because I believe the word of God. You have to understand, ladies and gentlemen, praise God, that where we are right now, amen, God is working on us. My God, let me say this to you. Let me say this to you, ladies and gentlemen, that whenever a vehicle, my God, needs servicing, my God, they bring the vehicle into the garage, my God Almighty, to service the vehicle. Can I say this to you? That you are just in a state where you are being serviced. God is changing your oil. God is changing your tires. He's fixing your engine. My God, he's aligning you. My God, because when you come out of this, you're about to look more better than how you came in. When you come out of this, you're about to be, my God Almighty, my God, somebody might have run into you and damaged your fender. My God, somebody might have run into your door. Somebody might have run into your back, but God is about to take you, my God, like a body man, like a mechanic, and he's about to beat up those things, my God, that happened to you up in the year that you did not have time to deal with. God is using this time for you to deal with some issues that are in your soul. Yes, my God, God is using this time for those of you who have not been communicating with your family members that you live with in the same yard, my God, and he's using this time for you to make things right at your yard before you can begin to make things right at church. Listen, you've been running from some stuff. You've been running from some people, but this pandemic has caused you to buck up in them, because both of you are in the same position, and you have to learn to beat out the dent in your vehicle. You've got to learn to beat out the fender. You've got to learn to beat out the door that they ran into. My God, they smashed your windshield. You're looking at them at a different way. You can't see them the way you used to see them before, but you know, fixing your windshield that your vision can be adjusted. My God Almighty, you're fixing yourself. My God, that the errors that were in you that blocked you from loving somebody, that blocked you from trusting somebody, that blocked you from depending on somebody, my God, this is not your end. And my God, God wants to move you, but first he has to deal with you. He has to deal with your issue. He has to deal with what is happening with you. He has to deal with it. Lord, God, I feel this word in my belly. This is not your end, because God has to prepare you for what is coming. My God, he has to prepare you for the highway that you're about to drive on. He has to prepare you for the people that you're going to meet. My God, because if they meet you with dents and bruises, busted and disgusted, my God, then you're going to rebel and react to them in the same way, because hurting people hurt people. But I came to let you know that God is about to put you on the potter's wheel. How does the potter do it? The potter takes the clay, he takes the pot, and he goes into private, and he breaks it down. My God Almighty, let me tell you something. God will not expose how he's breaking you down to other people, but he will do it in private. He will break you down in private. When you're sitting down in private, He will bring back the situation to mind. He will bring back the experiences to mind. God is not bringing it back to cause you to hurt, but he's bringing it back to mind for you to understand that before you can go forward, you have got to deal with this. Before you can go and impact the world, you have to deal with this. You got to be like the man that Jesus said, take up your bed and walk. My God, that the bed is no longer carrying you, but you are carrying the bed. That when you speak about your bed, it won't offend you anymore. When you speak about what people did, it won't offend you anymore, because the bed is no longer carrying you, but you are the one carrying the bed. Why? Because this is not your end. This is not where you will die, but God is dealing with you in the season of private. That when you come out, the people that thought you were this, when they hear you speak, when they hear you prophesy, when they hear you preach, when they hear you pray, they will say, you are not the same one I saw in January, but you are a different man. My God, when Peter got up on the day of Pentecost, my God, the man that they were looking for, it was not the man that was preaching. God is getting ready to turn your life around, because this is not your end, because the you that God sees, the you that the leader sees, is someone who is sanctified, ordained, and appointed. What did God say to Jeremiah? I sanctified you, I ordained you, I justified you. Those are all spiritual proclamations. But before you can get to it physically, you've got to remove the hindrances. You've got to remove the limitations. You've got to remove the yokes. You've got to remove, my God, the unforgiveness, the self-condemnation. You've got to remove the bad attitudes. This is what Paul says. Paul says, when I was a child, I thought as a child, but now I am old, I put away childish things. You got to understand that there's some things you can pray out, but there's some things you've got to move out. There's some things that you've got to make up in your mind that for where I am going, this cannot stay in my life. You've got to intentionally, consciously move it from out of your life. Can I talk to somebody? That God doesn't want to turn your life right upside down, but he wants to turn your life right side up. He wants to make you valuable. He wants to put value on your life. My God, but if your foundation is not set properly, if you don't dig out the dirt out of the well, if you don't cement over back your building, if you don't do a refurbishing, if you don't get out the junk, then you will still talk about the junk. If you don't get out the hurt, then you will still talk about the hurt. If you don't get out the church hurt, then you will still talk about the pastor that hurt you. You will still talk about the leader that hurt you. You will still talk about the member that hurt you. If you don't get out the church junk, ladies and gentlemen, then you will not be able to do it. This is not your end. My God Almighty. This is not your end. This is not Masitumba Gazidikotushkataya. Zimba de Kotosa. My God Almighty. Listen, as we are on this live right now, I want you to understand that God is saying to somebody right now on this live, God is saying to somebody that you need to understand that this is not your end. The you that you are seeing, let me say this to you. There is a difference between change and progress. Change happens automatically. You will grow old. You can change your shoes, you know, X, Y, Z. But progress is intentional. When a child is born, and if the child is reaching up to 6 months, 7 months, 8 months, 9 months, and the child is not yet walking, they won't say the child is not changing. They will say the child is not progressing. The child is not growing. Progress has to do with growth. Stop saying, I'm just waiting on the Lord to change me. I'm just waiting on the Lord to work on me. God is working on you, yes, but you've got to also work on yourself. Are you getting what I'm saying to you? You have to be intentional about progress. My God, if you have no ambition, then you won't know how to position yourself for progress. So I'm giving you this word. This is not your end. This is not your end. It means that you have to visualize in your mind, what is your end? You have to see in your mind, where do I want to go? I am currently right here. But where now do I want to go? Where do I see myself going? Where do I see myself in the next year? The next, my God, where do I see myself in the next 2 years? If this is not my end, then what is my end? The prophet said, write the vision, make it plain. My God, some of you need to start. Some of you need to revisit your vision book. Some of you need to revisit your vision that you had. Write the vision. Don't keep it in your head. Write the vision. Make it plain that they will see run after it. But though it tarry, my God Almighty, it shall come to pass. Are you getting what I'm saying to you this morning? Though it tarry, it shall come to pass. In closing, I'm saying this to you right now. In closing, that God is prophesying to us that COVID-19 is not our end. I hear what I'm saying to you. Quarantine, curfew, social distancing is not our end. Paul says, I perceive, and I'm just throwing this in there, that the current COVID of this time is not able to be compared with the glory that shall be revealed in you. What you are facing right now cannot be compared to what will be revealed in you. But can I say this to you? What will be revealed in you is dependent on if you prepare yourself for the glory. You have to prepare yourself for your glory. You have to prepare yourself for your glory. You have to prepare yourself. What was the instruction of preparation that God gave to Peter after he followed him? He said, wait in the upper room. And that is where you will get the power to do. There is a place of waiting. There is a place of waiting. There is a place of empowerment. Because Peter did not know that after he received power, opportunities will come. After you receive power, opportunity will come. Ladies and gentlemen, I challenge you in this season to don't be affected by COVID-19, but affect COVID-19. Affect your current environment. Affect your era. Affect your life. Let the Lord Jesus Christ show you in secret what are the hidden talents in me. Let God show you the issues that are in you. And I guarantee you by the grace and the power of God that when you begin to invest in yourself, when you begin to work on yourself, when this season is over, people will say, you are not the one that we saw last month. You are not the one that we saw last period. And I say this to you, find a leader, have a leader that will invest in you and say, listen, you're talking about you can't, I'm telling you that you can. You're saying you can't, I'm telling you that you can. I know that you can because you have the ability. Get a leader that will not agree to your pity party and agree to you. No, pastor, I can't do it. I don't think I can. Listen, your leader is here to tell you that I'm not thinking that you can. I know that you can because I'm seeing what is on the inside of you. The Lord bless you today. The Lord bless you today. The Lord bless you. And the Lord strengthen you in Jesus' name. I know, hand over back to Dr. Taylor right now. Amen. Amen, Rev. I think your mic is mute.
Yeah, bless you, sir. Bless you. Thank you for so succinctly sharing the word of God to us this morning. I'm going to just ask you before you go to just pray for those who are on this live, those who may be even struggling with identifying, you know, who they are, you know, maybe in that same pity party that you spoke about, who in this season may not be investing in themselves. I just want you to lift up a prayer for them before we go.
Amen. Amen. Father, we just give you praise. We just thank you for what you are doing. And God, we decree and we declare in the name of Jesus Christ that, Lord, that you will stir your people to revelation. Stir them to a place of revelation. I pray that those who believe that this is their end, that they don't think that they have enough, that you will bring revelation to them. I decree, mighty God, that even as Gideon did not know that he was a mighty man of valor, but someone had to bring it to his attention. God, I pray that you will bring to their attention in this season, that you have wells of income. You have streams in you. You have power in you. You have the ability in you. Father, cause your people to not be sorry for themselves or worrying Where will the finances come from? You say, Father, that look at the lilies. Look at the birds. Look, do they worry? You said, take no thought for tomorrow, because tomorrow is taking care of itself. You said you shall supply all our needs according to your riches in glory. And so, God, I decree a blessing over your people today. I decree a breakthrough over your people today. I decree, mighty God, that you will bless them. That you will bless them. That you will bless. I decree in the name of Jesus Christ. Yes. That the spirit of inspiration will come upon them even now. The spirit of inspiration will come upon them. Witty ideas, my God. Yes. Ideas will come upon them. I decree in the name of Jesus that you will cause their eyes to be open to see what the people have need of now. What, my God, what is the need now? And that they will see it and turn it into a business. I decree, Father, cause your people to look into their hand, look into their surroundings, as the woman did, and see that she only had a cruse of oil. But when she used it, Father God, you told her to gather pots that she can pour out. I pray in the name of Jesus that as they begin to use what you have given them, that you will command God an overflow and overflow and overflow and overflow. Yes. In the name of Jesus Christ, I decree the resources of heaven. I decree the blessings and the favor of heaven to come upon your people in this season and in this time, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Father, we bless you, we thank you, we give you glory. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. God bless you, sir. And again, thank you for joining us. It was a pleasure having you. God bless you, listeners. It was indeed a pleasure. This is not your end. I do trust that you would have been inspired and you would have been spurred into action this morning, because even in famine, you shall be blessed. Man of God, encourage us. Let us use this time to invest in self. As we have been saying over these weeks, what is it you have always wanted to do? Now is the time. Start writing that book. Start that business plan. Start putting together that proposal for the next conference. Start putting together that proposal for the next big idea. What is it? In this period, I'm declaring that lying in you is that million-dollar idea, that billionaire idea, that idea to revolutionize not only your life, but your family and the ministry. So invest in self. It is not your end. And so I challenge you to take the words of the Lord as spoken through his prophet, Minister Tevaun Brown, and move into action. God bless you. Thanks for joining us this week for another dynamic session of worship and the word. On the behalf of the leadership team at the Pentecostal Redemption Church, Linstead and Trafalgar, I want to express our deepest thanks, gratitude for your continued engagement through this medium. You could have tuned into any other broadcast, but you stayed and you continue to tune into us. Continue to tell a friend about the broadcast. Join us on Wednesday for Night Fast, when we'll have another powerful, dynamic service. A prophetess will be in the house. I want to say to us that, again, we want to help those who are less fortunate and those who are most vulnerable in this time of pandemic. And so we want to engage and continue to engage in a welfare program through this pandemic, and it's really an expansion of our welfare program as we do this or have been doing this before COVID-19. It is now, and there is now a bigger need So we encourage you to sow into this ministry. The numbers are running at the bottom of the screen, or you can make contact and we will inform you how to give or how we can arrange for that to happen. Thanks then. Until we meet on Wednesday, I am your lead pastor, Reverend Dervon Dale Taylor, encouraging you as always to ask God, God, what is your plan for the rest of the day? Make me a part of it. That's how we are going to change the world, friends. Also be reminded that any change we want to see must begin with us. Stay safe, stay blessed, stay prayed up. Remember, follow the instructions that are given out to stay safe during this period. Wash your hands, sanitize, social distancing, stay home, and with God in our vessels and responsibility, personal responsibility, we will make it through this storm. God bless you. Have a good and a godly day. Goodbye. This is not my end. Go ahead. Hashtag share time. Have a good day.